If you are having trouble staying positive, it is so important to have a good, healthy mindset. And that's what we're going to talk about tonight. So, tip number one is remember that dating is a journey, not a destination. The destination is love, and you certainly need to keep love in mind when you're dating, but it is a journey. And if you don't enjoy the journey, you will be upset, depressed every time it doesn't work out. So, how do you enjoy the journey? Well, first of all, remember that dating is a bunch of no's until you get to your big yes. That's really what it is. You're looking for one big, juicy, delicious yes. And so just expect the no's. Expect that most men are not going to be a good match. Tip number two, be mindful about what you say and do on your dates. Now, it's easy to blame men and say, men are jerks, and wow, why do I just keep meeting so many, low-level guys? But I want you to do what you can about you, because you're the only one you can do anything about. And first of all, be really, scrutinizing about the guys that you meet. And I want you to be like super, super ruthless about being picky about the right things. But think about yourself and how you're showing up on dates. And people tend to misread cues all the time. We do it and men do it. So when you're on a date, a couple things to steer clear of that often gets misconstrued is saying things like, I never or I always. Those are things that you may not even mean. So things like a guy says, so you live in Florida. What do you think about New York? And you might say, oh, I would never live in New York. It's just too crowded. And you might not really mean that. You might mean that the experiences you've had in New York City have been kind of loud and crowded, but that with for the right guy, maybe you would be open to living in New York City or maybe in the suburbs right near New York City. So many times men will write a woman off because they hear an I never or I always. Every date is a learning experience. It's an opportunity for you to learn about yourself and learn about a man. So I call this my 3-2-3-2 method, and here's how it works. After every date, I want you to write down three things you liked about him, two things that you didn't like, if there are any, yellow or red flags. And then three things that you thought you did really well on the date, and two things that you might do differently on the next date. Maybe you were really proud that you didn't share a negative story about your past, but next time you'd like to speak up in a more empowered way. These are all things that we're learning, and that makes the dating a journey and a joyous journey, a joyful journey, instead of drudgery. So stay open and curious and positive on your journey to love. Tip number three is be good to yourself. So what's really important is that you don't come undone after every bad date. And if you're feeling down, get out, do something fun, do something uplifting, get together with your friends, go for a massage, go for a hike, go biking, do what makes you happy. If you're active, it's going to boost your endorphins. It's going to make you in a much better mood. And we all need to take breaks from dating every once in a while, but don't take too long of a break because here's what happens. We start to find reasons not to date again. We start to think that it's just too scary or too depressing, and we don't get right back in the saddle. So if you fell off your bike, hopefully you'd get back on your bike again. So I want you to try different things, mix it up. If one thing doesn't work, try something else because something is going to work. If your future partner is out there, but if you don't date, you're not going to find him. Tip number four is be grateful for what is going well in your life right now. In order to stay optimistic, it's so important to have a gratitude practice. There is something to be grateful for every single day. And so you can develop a gratitude practice however it works for you, whether you're writing in a gratitude journal or you're doing a gratitude meditation. Just really focus on the good. A positive attitude is one of the most important things that you can bring to dating and relationships. That's how you become a dating optimist, not a dating pessimist, because you're going to exude positive energy throughout your whole life, and you're going to bring that positive energy to every date. And when the right guy shows up, you're going to be glad that you didn't give up hope, but that you stayed in the dating game.